Hey Siri, turn on the matter accessory.
Okay, the matter accessory is on.
Finally, we are here. Apple officially supports Matter through Apple's HomeKit. Believe it or not, it can be expected that in the future, smart home devices will be built on Matter, so we have to prepare for the new era of the smart home device. This is the first Matter accessory I made as a demo. One ESP32-S3 DEVKit can turn into a great smart lamp. That's really cool. Also, it can be turned on and off through Siri, and it works very easily with Apple's HomeKit, so you can control it from the out of your home. In this video, I'm gonna cover starting with installing Matter framework and build example app called the Lightning app for ESP32-S3.
Hey Siri, turn off the Matter accessory.
Okay, the Matter accessory is off.
Let me introduce the heroes of this project. First up is the ESP32-S3 DEVKit C. Since it is an N8R8, it has an 8MB flash and 8MB PS RAM. It doesn't matter though. Also, since an RGB LED is attached to the board, this will give you the color you want. This is the reason why I choose this one. No need to wire anything. In the end, I will control this LED from my iPhone's home app. Apple TV is important in this project. You must set up a home hub to add Matter accessories to the home app. So you need a device like Apple TV or HomePod or iPad. According to the article, the iPad can no longer be used as a home hub. This hasn't been officially announced yet, but it looks like it'll be out of support soon. That's not good. Apple TV automatically becomes a home hub when you add it to HomeKit, so all you need to sign in to iCloud with your Apple ID. For your information, Apple TV can be used from the 4th generation or later. And I'm gonna add the Matter accessory I made on my iPhone and control it through a home app. With this, today's project begins. Let's get the Matter framework. The first thing we need to do is check out the Matter code. Let's proceed one by one by following the building guide they provide. This project contains many submodules. It took me about an hour to download all of them. Probably because many people started developing Matter, I think it might be. The way I see it, it will be good for you to work out for a while if you just get started. There is something I want to mention while we wait. You must develop using ESP-IDF, so I recommend that you use Visual Studio Code. Installing ESP-IDF is very detailed and expressive. Also, there's a tutorial for using VS Code. If you add them one by one, there is no problem preparing the development environment. I assume you have a ESP-IDF and Visual Studio Code ready. As you can see, I develop in a Mac environment, so I will set it for Mac OS. If you are using a different OS, please install it accordingly. Checkout is over. An hour has passed. It's crazy. The next thing we need to do is to set up some necessary settings for the build. You must have Xcode and Brew. If you don't have them, install them first. This is a required process for Mac only. I also use Intel Mac, so I use this method. In order for pkgconfig to work properly, make a symbolic link from the pkgconfig in OpenSSL to the newly installed pkgconfig. I have a version of 1.11q OpenSSL installed, not 1.11g, so I'll make it for this. I'm ready to set up the environment. Please install the necessary parts according to the OS you are using first. Now it's just setting for the environment. Set all environment variables required to build the project. Let's move to the top level folder and run the activate script. Finally, we can see this welcome screen. Welcome to Matter Activator. It says this sets your share environment variables. Like above, if you can see this message, environment passes or checks, it means that the necessary settings for building the project are now ready. It's time to build all sources, libraries, and tests for the host platform. For the build, it uses GN and Ninja here. GN is a Matter build system that generates build files for Ninja, and then Ninja uses build.ninja files to define build rules. Ninja is a small build system with a focus on speed. Ninja is used building Google Chrome, parts of Android, and LLVM. We can build our project with this. ESP-IDF also used Ninja to build the project. If you need more detailed information, I recommend Googling it. You can find a bunch of information about it. Seems like all done. Let me run all tests. There are no errors, so all tests were completed without any problems. Let me try this again to confirm. Here, we can confirm no work to do. That means that the test passed in the previous build. The preparation of Matter is over. Next, let's deploy an example officially supported by Matter to my ESP32-S3. The example I'll be using is the Lightning app. If you use the ESP32-S3 DEVKit, you can control the RGB LED on the board without modifying the source code. This is a target project. Let me open VS Code here. I'm currently using ESP-IDF version 4.4.2. Hang on, let me resize the window. I do not modify anything in this project, just I will select the connected port and set the target port to ESP32-S3. That's it. I'm waiting for the target setting done. It's all done, let me build it. It's starting to build the first Matter project. I hope there's no issue. For ESP32-S3, the edit pin is set to 48. If your board has RGB LEDs connected to other GPIOs, please edit config LED GPIO in SDK config. If there is a problem with the build, first check that the ESP-IDF build works properly in your VS Code. Also, if you run into problems with the Matter framework, please try running the activate script again in the bash terminal. The build task was done without any issues. After flashing to the device, open the monitor and check the local console. Currently, the device doesn't have any connections. It continues to wait for an external connection. It uses a QR code to make a connection. If you look in the console, you can find the link. When you click the link, a QR code is automatically generated through the web. What a good process. I'm trying to register this as a new accessory through the home app of my iPhone. Just read the QR code through the app. Oh my god, looks like my Apple TV isn't 6.1 yet. I need to update my Apple TV. Let me do this first. My Apple TV is now up to date. Let me try to add my device again. QR code scanning is done. I will show you my iPhone. At this time, it went to the screen that says connecting to accessory. Feeling good. It says uncertified accessory. Of course, as this is a demo, accessories are not certified. I will discuss device certification again when I have a chance. Hang on a second. Oh, finally, it's connected. I'm so happy with this. Set an accessory name. It also has basic wire automation settings. My first Matter accessory was registered in my home. This is awesome. I wonder how it works. Let's change the color of the light. Can you see this? It works like a smart lamp. You can set not only the color you want, but also the brightness. The overall quality seems to be very good because it's used within the Apple Home app. Everything works very well. What I'm gonna test this time is what if I can control Matter accessories if I'm not on the same network. I have no doubt it will work, but let's test it. As you can see here, I'm currently connected to LTE and turned off Wi-Fi. Yep, it works fine. It works seamlessly. The currently supported device types are as follows. Most types of basic home devices are supported. I wonder how the camera part will be supported in the future. Making Matter accessories with ESP32 is very interesting. This will definitely enable more projects. I will try my best to do as many projects as possible. Today's ends here. Thank you for watching. See you on the next project.